they hold it. Michael Chiavello hits Chelsea with you early. Leg kicks we spoke about before. Coming from Folayang early. Look for Buist to go inside the phone booth and throw the knees. Buist is just a huge individual.
It's a gigantic lightweight. Look at that range that he's got. How is he going to utilize it?
7-match winning streak for Pieter Buist of the Netherlands. A Muay Thai and kickboxing stylist who is devastating with the knees. Folayang, look for the leg kicks, the cutting side kicks, the spinning back fists, and the turning back kicks to the liver section. Big inside leg kick from Folayang. Folayang, last time he outstruck a great kickboxer was when he beat Amir Khan. Totally dominated Amir Khan in the striking. And he did the same to Buist tonight. Spinning back elbow there from Folayang.
Buist is a different kind of animal, especially the way that he closes his distance. His footwork is beautiful, and those stance changes are going to, you know, present a problem to Folayang.
The spins of Folayang are many and varied, and Buist just going to be careful, whether it's the spinning back kick, the spinning back elbow, the spinning back fist. If there was such a thing as a spinning back knee, Folayang would be the man to create it. Folayang faking with the jab. Oh, groin strike, accidental. It's a clear cut.
Drops Buist, immediately hits the canvas. Buist is going to get 5 minutes of injury time.
Have a look at this.
It's just that, it's that signature cutting sidekick that Folayang likes to use over and over again. And it looks like he just kind of stomps the groin there of Pieter Buist. Buist looks to be okay. I don't think he wants to break the rhythm that he's kind of built up in this first stanza.
Only a short injury break for Buist. He's okay to go on here. Referee Kim Chin says, watch the range there, Edward. They recommence first round. Buist. Ready. Eyes on go. Christian Lee. And not look past Folayang though here tonight. Folayang also has eyes on Christian Lee. Cutting side kick there from the Wushu megastar. Former world's lightweight champion Edward Folayang. As we said earlier, about a week ago, was awarded as one of the top 50 Philippines athletes of all time alongside Manny Pacquiao. That's it!
Wow, that head kick was beautiful as he wrapped that foot around the back of the head of Folayang, but then answered right back up with a right hand. The veteran that he is immediately goes inside the clinch to regain his wits.
Now he's hoping for a choke.
Watch for the knees.
Can he find a choke on Folayang? Has 6 submission wins and 16 victories to Pieter Buist.
He's a bit high for the guillotine, but he might be able to make adjustments. A little hard with that arm in to complete the guillotine, but those long arms are going to give him the ability to make adjustments if necessary, especially if Folayang starts to scramble.
Folayang with a takedown.
And to get that takedown and land inside control.
Pieter Buist, 86-12 Muay Thai, record 18 knockouts, 45-10 in judo. Side control here for Edward Folayang. Can throw the knees, can throw the elbows, cuts the hips in, does the landslide.
Buist's training partners is Reiner De Ridder, who is getting ready for his shot coming up in Jakarta against Leandro Ataides. So he has been on the ground with some very high-level jiu-jitsu practitioners. So let's see what Buist can do off of his back now in a bad position in side control. Buist is trying to wrap up that half guard, might be able to suck that leg in.
You know, 5 years ago, here inside the Mall of Asia Arena, the crowd would have been quiet when it went to the ground. But now they're an educated grappling crowd in the Philippines. And they're loving this! Folayang! Hoping to choke out Buist!
Nice little scramble by Buist to avoid that possible guillotine from Folayang. Now Folayang's got that front headlock position. Look for the knees.
Buist covers up, and here come the knees into the skull of the man from the Netherlands. Buist back to his feet. Knees to the midsection from Folayang. Buist with no place to go. Under a minute remaining. First round of 3. It's been a back and forth seesawing contest. Both men have had their opportunities. Both men have thrown the heavy artillery.
It might come down to that last takedown there landed by Folayang. on chop, talking, so a little bit of dominance. Baus needs to turn the match quickly in his favor right now.
And Folayang stopped the streak of Pieter Buist. Can he derail the title aspirations of the Dutchman? Looks for a takedown, doesn't get it. Buist speaks around, takes the back standing. And now Folayang looks to turn back into him and does just that. Spinning backwards and the hip kick from Buist. Buist goes for the headache maker. Takes a big outside side kick just above the knee. Back from a perennial nerd. There's a cutting side kick from Folayang. What a gripping opening round of action. One kick from Buist. Overhand right for Folayang. Good stiff lead hand there. Turning back into the ridge from Folayang. Spinning techniques of Folayang that we highlighted earlier. Spinning back fist there from the Russian style. Big tough thumping leg kick. Solid right hand from Buist. Now they tie up. Folayang backs him against the wall. Overhook from a Don from Pieter Buist.
You typically don't see a lot of spinning techniques coming from Dutch kickboxers, and I asked Pieter Buist about that. He says they like them, they appreciate them, but they've also developed a series of counters for them. Right now he's having a bit of a hard time with the diversity of attacks coming from Eduard Folayang. He needs to read these things a little bit better and start going back to the basics.
Buist has not had the opportunity to get his knees off as much as he would have hoped. Folayang closed down the number one weapon of the Dutchman.
More action.
Hipping him pressed against the circle fence now. Nice corgi near the inside thigh there, that femoral profunda area. This crowd in Manila will go absolutely bananas if Folayang can sub out or knock out Pieter Buist. Little peppering palm heel strikes there from Buist.
You can see Buist is using an overhook to kind of keep Folayang up high so he's not able to drop down and change levels and go after the double leg takedown. So it's a good strategy on Baust's part, but you can see the pressure coming from Folayang as well. I like how he's mixing up these things by striking and then also adding a lot of pressure to keep Buist up against the circle wall to avoid those knees.
The former world champion, Eduard Folayang, is a whole different ball game inside the closed guard. 2 minutes 35 remaining, second of three. Crossing elbow there from Folayang. Buist throws up those long legs. Hoping to lock and choke here. Hoping for the arm of Folayang. Folayang could be in trouble.
That's what those legs give you. They give you the ability to snatch up arm bars and triangles from very bad positions. That triangle choke might be in.
Can he do it? Can he do it? This crowd trying to rally behind Folayang. Belly down arm bar now. No, Folayang's out of trouble. They are going absolutely bananas for one of the top 50 Philippine athletes of all time. Eduard Folayang inside of half guard on Pieter Buist of Holland.
He's trying to free his arms so he can possibly push down on the thighs of Buist to slide into past the half guard. Buist is doing a good job controlling the head and maintaining this position.
1 minute 10 remains. Second round of three. It was a good first round for Folayang. Buist has had his opportunities in the second. Folayang still inside the half guard.
Now Buist has got that underhook on that side. He can start to shrink over and escape onto his hip. Might be able to create a little bit of space here. Folayang's got heavy hips. Able to flatten him out.
Just to drop the elbow on the beard of the Dutchman. First elbow to the body from Folayang.
What the fish?
Familiar red trunks of Team Lacar, of Eduard Folayang. Reversal! hooks on Folayang's guy.
Beautiful bridge to get back into a more dominant position, but he's got to put in work. These past 5 minutes have been all Folayang.
Oh, he's gone from Folayang. Opens it up now. Final 10 seconds. Gax postures up. Tries to land the right hand. And immediately controls the posture. There's Folayang. Closes the guard. And we close out the second round.
He seems a little bit tender on his legs. Something might be wrong with a knee or a possible ankle. Let's see what Buist does here. And see if he's closed that distance, utilize those knees. We typically see Buist flurry him with punches. Get right into that clinch. And then start dropping those knees on, but Blink's doing a great job of maintaining his distance. He's either all the way in or all the way out, making it very hard for Buist to utilize those knees.
Skip in there, sideways, Quint Folayang. Inside leg kick, Buist goes up to the forearm, then goes to the head and wobbles it! The head kick wobbles Folayang, here comes Buist, tags him with the right hand, North South position now. Front headlock from Pieter Buist. Can he find a sub? Can he find a finish? Pieter Buist is trying. Folayang in trouble. And now gets out of trouble. There's the high knee from Buist. And presses Folayang back like against the circle fence.
Oh, I think Pieter Buist had a golden opportunity to slip away. He wobbled Folayang with that head kick. You can see the equilibrium start to shuffle a little bit. And he was able to regain his wits and shoot right in for a takedown.
Should he have gone to the head again?
I would have liked to see him keep that range, start letting go of the punches. And you can see that he wobbled and he just didn't fully commit to the oncoming attack. And he allowed Folayang to get that body lock and close that distance. That's the second time that he's done that. But what that shows is that shows internal damage, which is the second highest category of our judging criteria. That's going to shoot him way up into the judges' scorecards.
Muay Thai clinch now from back. The Muay Thai styling. No jump for the knees as he drops levels with Folayang. Overhook on the left arm from Buist. Will he rue the missed opportunity after? Visibly wobbling Eduard Folayang with the head kick a few moments ago.
Yeah, but that's going to count as internal damage. That little bit of equilibrium shuffle that he had to go through to regain his wits. That's going to score heavily in the judges' eyes. I'd like to see him do a little bit something more right now with this position. Spin off, go back to the strikes. Wrestling with Eduard Folayang is not the way he's going to win this matchup right now.
What's Folayang looking to do here, Dragon?
You can see he's got the underhook on this side. I think he's just trying to regain his sense of awareness after being wobbled by that head kick. He might be fully composed right now, but I think now he's just trying to drop those knees in, soften up the legs of Pieter Buist, because he doesn't want to eat another one of those head kicks.
Buist tries to lock on the meet and greet for the high knee, and Folayang a little too slick, a little too evasive. 2 minutes 5 remains, third and final round. Folayang circles off clockwise. High kick comes again from Buist. Folayang flies to it.
Folayang needs to glue his left hand to the side of his head right now, because Pieter Buist is going for that head kick knockout right now.
Not lead with his head here, Folayang. And like the Dragon said, needs to plaster that left hand to the side of the head. There's a right hand lead from Buist. 1:40 now on the clock. Cracks away to the outside. That lead knee was Folayang. He was going to town on that lead leg in the opening round. Has slowed down a little with the leg attacks. There's one to the top of the thigh. High kick off the left leg that time from Buist. Body shot from Folayang. Resets to the Filipino. Thought about a spinning back fist. Thought about it again. Snaking left hand there from Buist. Backs up Folayang. Folayang looking to spin. Shifts off, and the weight changes. You know he's about to spin, whether it's a turning back kick or the spinning back fist. 100 minutes to go, and maybe still anyone's going to take it. Who can go kleptomaniac and try to steal it in the final 45 seconds? Big leg kick from Buist. Folayang, thought about the lead leg, the lead knee, the common peroneal nerve, but didn't take it. Now switches starts. Inside leg kick from Folayang, then a side kick.
Oh, beautiful by Eduard Folayang to catch that kick. That was a pivotal takedown, much needed in the dying 30 seconds of this round. Buist needs to
great respect from two amazing athletes.
The most significant strike of this matchup, despite maybe that first round head kick landed by Buist by the right hand, was this. Look at that, beautifully done, and it caught him as he was coming around. So his balance was already slightly off. You can see the little chicken dance that he did. Look at that, beautifully lifts up his leg. The things that Pieter Buist does are technically beautiful. He avoids the leg kick by lifting up his leg, timing it beautifully. As soon as the leg comes down, he wraps that shin around the chin of Eduard Folayang, scoring a beautiful head kick that wobbled Eduard Folayang. What a performance, what a matchup between two of the very best in the lightweight division.
Okay. Dom Lau, without decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Assistant Vice President for Marketing of Morris Garages Philippines, Mr. Jun Manese. And now, after three rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of the blue corner. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of the red corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision from the